Thank you. so much. We're going to skip over the next piece in the program and jump to the third piece, which is called Cantate Domino. It's by a composer named Hans Leo Hassler. And if you have been coming to all the concerts in the year, you know that we have been focusing on three countries for composers this year: Germany, Austria, and the Czech Republic. The reason I programmed music from those countries is because in the spring, just about a month ago, 30 of us were able to go to those three countries on a vocal music tour. So the whole department kind of studied those countries and did music from them, and now we get to perform some of it for you. So Hans Leo Hassler was actually a choir director in Nuremberg, and it was the first place we visited on our trip. So we're gonna sing one of his pieces. It's called Cantate Domino. It's basically sing joyfully to God, and you'll hear basically every voice part in this piece kind of has their own line that's important, and you'll hear them coming in at different times, and it's very fun to get the whole thing to fit together in a good puzzle piece. So enjoy. This is Hassler's Cantate Domino. we'll bring the honors group back in a minute, but we're going to actually begin our solos to kind of transition us throughout the concert tonight. We have four solos tonight. We had just really, really strong, great auditions for this concert. So we decided to let four of them in. We had eight really strong solos, so we ended up with four of them. Excited for me, always neat when they audition, is we had two freshmen get the solos, and then a junior and a senior. So our first solo tonight is, and they're all kind of, the first two are kind of in this, I don't know, melancholy, like, breakup, romance kind of song. You know, those are our favorites. Our first one is called Jar of Hearts. The first song is called Jar of Hearts. If you've seen the show So You Think You Can Dance, it was actually featured on that show, and then it was released like a week later. It's by an artist named Christina Perry, and the song got pretty famous and pretty good notoriety after the So You Think You Can Dance performance, when it was a couple together, song to dance together. But it's a beautiful song, and actually it's one of our freshmen will be singing it to start the solos tonight. So if you can please help bring to the stage Miss Riley Casey. Come on up.
I've grown to
So she just sang that with walking ammonia. I don't even know what walking ammonia is. So our Norse Wing Choir is coming up to the stage next. They have a three-song set in the middle of our show here. The Norse Wing Choir does different music than the Honors Ensemble for the spring concert, so we like for them to do their own set. The first two songs that they're performing are by Joseph Haydn. Again, keeping with our theme, he was an Austrian composer. He is much more known for his instrumental work. If you've ever played in an orchestra, you've probably played one of his symphonies. He's known as the father of the symphony, so someone that really pioneered the art of the symphony. And for a little bit of time, he mentored Beethoven, but more than anything, he's known for the symphonies. He was an Austrian composer, but he did have a lot of fame and notoriety in England, and he did some time in the courts in England, and that's where he did a lot of his work. He was known as a celebrity over there, so his concerts would sell out as soon as they knew that he was performing. It's always interesting for me to think about when we're talking about Haydn's time. It might be the only time you ever hear a piece of music. So imagine your favorite song, and the only time you ever get to hear it is if you hear it live in person. And it might be once. That's the idea like of an encore, you know, where we bring out the people again. Maybe they wanted to hear it again because it was the only time they were ever going to hear it in their lives. So think about that. Now, I asked the choir, and they said I should tell you. They told me to tell you the story, but it's kind of morbid, it's kind of weird. So Haydn, the composer, when he died, it's kind of really weird. So when he died, these two people that were interested in this study called phrenology, it's like where you examine the physical traits of a brain to see if you could tell people were geniuses and that kind of thing. So when Haydn died, two people asked the gravedigger, Haydn's gravedigger, to chop off his head, Haydn's head, so they could study it. And the gravedigger was like, sure, I'll do it. So they take Haydn's head, and then for 145 years, his head and his body are not the same place. And his burial process takes 145 years. They put in his grave, in his tombstone, like a temporary head. And now, if you ever go see Haydn's tomb where his memorial is, inside the casket, there are actually two skulls. I don't know why I wanted to share that with you, but I'm just saying that to you, so sorry to inflict that on you. But anyway, so that's a fun fact about Haydn. And now we're going to sing his music. That's good. Thank you. So if you can, we're going to perform these two psalms. They were some of the only works that Haydn wrote in English. We're going to perform the two psalms in a row without any stopping. There'll just be a little pause for the organ, and then I'll tell you about our third song. So enjoy, these are the first two of Haydn's psalms. choir set here in the middle is called Laudate Jehovah, and this is a Baroque piece of music from the Baroque time. The thing we've talked about in class is there's the idea of these dynamic shifts, so like in the Baroque time, instead of having gradual volume changes, kind of like in the first three songs you heard tonight, the dynamics are called terraced, like a terrace apartment. So the dynamics might be low and then just jump up suddenly with no gradual in between. So you'll hear that tonight, and also you'll hear this song has three kind of distinct sections. There's kind of the opening idea, there's a slow middle section that switches to three time, so I'll conduct it like a triangle so you can see that. And then the end peaks back up into a two. It's called cut time, so two beats in every measure. So it's got a little pop, a little fireworks at the end of it. So please enjoy. This is Telemann's arrangement of Laudate Jehovah.
Thank you.
choirs, we're breaking it up with solos. So our second solo for tonight is Tiffany Trump, and she's going to be singing a song that many of you know, probably most popularly recorded by Norah Jones. Norah Jones didn't actually write the song, it's called Don't Know Why. Norah Jones didn't write the song, it was actually written by a guy named Jesse Harris. But as is common in music these days, people cover songs, and the covered versions sometimes become more popular than the original. The song earned Norah Jones 3 Grammys for it. So when you hear it, just kind of have that in the back of your head, but definitely fits in with our melancholy, unrequited love breakup songs so far this evening. So please, I sense her presence to my right already. Please join me in welcoming Tiffany Trong from the Don't Know Why. Again, not really known for his choral music at all. If you you've ever played in an orchestra, you might have played his music called The Planets, or you might have heard it. It's probably his most popular orchestral suite of music called The Planets. But I love these little gems of choral music that you can find sometimes when the instrumental composers decide to take the crack at writing choral music. It turns out beautiful, and the way they write the music, kind of with an understanding of how instruments work, kind of translates really interestingly to their voice. You could think of, if you've been to or seen the churches in Venice, there's a church called St. Mark's, and it has these really awesome little chapel domes. And there was a style of choir music that came out of there. It was called polychoral, P-O-L-Y, choral, where you'd have choirs on different sides of the church, and they would sing different things. One would sing, and then the other would sing, and sometimes they would all sing together. Pulse kind of modeled this piece after that style. So you'll hear the sopranos and altos split into four part, and then the tenor bass split into four part. So they kind of bounce back and forth, and then at the end it gets more heavy and more heavy, and then they kind of meet at the very end together. So you'll kind of hear how that plays out. But the piece starts in a very interesting chord that just kind of builds from the bass all the way up to the soprano. So enjoy this piece. It's called Nunc Dimittis. It's by Gustav Holst.
Thank you.
love that piece so much. Oh my gosh, it's so fun to conduct. We're going to have our third of four solos tonight, and then we're going to combine the chamber and advanced women's right after that for another treat for you. Our third soloist is another freshman. She's kind of doing the singer-songwriter thing too, which is really exciting. And so it's always neat to see when people in the choir have their other talents playing instruments, writing songs, covering songs. So I'm definitely excited to bring her up. Ready there. This is Amelie Simpson to my left, your right, and she's going to be singing If It Hadn't Been for Love by the Steel Drivers. So it's a cover, and she's going to be accompanying herself on guitar. So please enjoy.
Her poetry is in the public domain, so that means any composer can take
take those poems and set them to music. So you'll have a lot of people using Sarah Teasdale's poems for choral music. It's very evocative, and you'll hear the lyrics, "Only in sleep I see their faces, children I played with when I was a child." So it's kind of like reminiscing about your childhood. You can think of your favorite kindergarten buddies and kind of just seeing them as you dream. It's a beautiful poem, and Eschenwaltz did a great job setting it. For this piece, we're going to have chamber and advanced women's join together. They kind of are going to form this kind of serene backdrop of choral wash. It's kind of these chords that kind of just sink into place. And it's a great, this church is a great church to sing this piece in, so you'll really enjoy it. Ariana Johnson is going to be singing the solo for you tonight. And this piece is called Only in Sleep. Enjoy.
Thank you.
is called Jesu Dulcis Memoria, the sweet memory of Jesus. This one could be sung by four people, one soprano, one alto, one tenor, one bass, and it's four of them in a giant cathedral like this, and it would exist fine on its own. But we're trying to do it with 120 people. So the parts have to fit very right in, just have to be super locked in for this to work with 120 people, but it's still neat to hear the different voices all doing text at a little bit different time. It's one of those pieces that was written about 500 years ago. It's attributed to a Spanish composer named Tomás Luis de Victoria, but we actually don't know that he wrote it for sure. In fact, we're pretty sure he did not write it. He just gets the credit for it. So the actual author is unknown, one of those mysteries of music that hasn't been uncovered yet. Maybe will someday, but it's still a beautiful piece of music. Enjoy this with Jesu Dulcis Memoria.
Thank you.
as the Norseman choir comes up for our final two songs, I wanted to do something.